Hello everyone, welcome back to tenorshare. Have you tried the new macOS Sequoia? I have, and after a few days of use, I find it less satisfying than I hoped. The new features seem like just a standard update to me. What I was really looking forward to was the AI feature, but Apple has announced that it will be available in the fall. So I think it's a good time for me to downgrade. If you feel the same, here's how to do it. If you haven't backed up your data, now is the time to use Time Machine to back up your entire Mac. Downgrading will erase all data on your machine. Connect an external drive to be the data backup device. Hover over the dock. Select System Settings, then select General. In the right column, select Time Machine. Continue to select Add Backup Disk. The external drive you have connected will appear. Click Setup Disk. Finally, click Done and wait for the backup process. The time can be long or short, depending on the amount of data in your machine. In this step, we will create a USB drive containing the macOS installer. Now plug in the USB with at least 16 GB capacity into the device and we go to the next step. Go to Launchpad and select App Store. In the search bar, type macOS Sonoma and press Enter to search. On the right, the macOS Sonoma app will appear. Click the View button. Continue by selecting Get, then click Download and wait for the system to download the data. After the download is complete, click the yellow button to minimize the installer. Next, open Terminal by selecting Launchpad, choosing the other folder and selecting Terminal. Type the command sudo, followed by a space. Then, open Finder, in the left column select Applications. Find the macOS Sonoma installer icon. Right-click and select Show Package Contents. Continue by opening the Contents folder, then Resources. Here, find the file Create Install Media and drag and drop it into the Open Terminal window. Then type the command volume followed by a space. Now go to the main screen, drag and drop the USB icon into Terminal, and press Enter to start the process. Enter your password to unlock the machine, and press Enter again. Note that the password will not be displayed while you type. Continue. Press the Y key and press Enter. Select Allow if asked for access permission. Now wait a bit for the process to complete. Thus, it is complete. Now turn off your machine. For Macs with Apple Silicon chips, hold down the power button continuously until you enter the boot options. For Macs with Intel chips, press the power button to turn on the machine. Then hold the Option key. In case you cannot access the installer, you need to take an additional step to enter recovery mode by pressing the power button to turn on, then holding the Command R combination until you enter recovery mode. From the menu bar, select Utilities, then select Startup Security Utility. Enter your password to unlock the machine for access. In the Allowed Boot Media section, select Allow Booting from External or Removable Media. Now repeat the step of accessing the boot options and you will see the Sonoma installer. Select it. Click Next and enter your password to unlock. Then select Disk Utility and click Continue. Select the Macintosh HD drive. Then click Erase and select Erase again to clean the drive. Once done, click Done. And click the red button to return to the original menu. Select Install macOS Sonoma and click Continue. Continue by selecting Continue. Select Agree to agree to the terms. Here, select the drive to install the operating system as Macintosh HD and click Continue. Then you just need to wait for the installation process to take place. During this process, the Mac may restart, be patient, and do not use the machine during the process. Currently, my Mac has finished installing and started setting up. At the Migration Assistant step, connect the drive where you backed up your data. Then select from a Mac, Time Machine, or startup disk, then click Continue. When the system finds your backup, select it and click Continue. Once again, select Continue. Now you will need to set a password to unlock your Mac. Then click Set Password and select Continue. The data recovery process will take place. After this process, you just need to complete a little more setup. And we are back to macOS Sonoma. Just now, there were quite a few steps, and many of you might find it a bit complicated. so we have another more stable, reliable, and faster way, which is to use tenorshare ReiBoot. Use another computer, not the Mac that needs to be downgraded. Download and install tenorshare ReiBoot. From the main page of the software, select More Features, choose macOS Upgrade, Downgrade. Continue by selecting Downgrade. Then you can choose the correct version of your Mac to get accurate instructions on how to connect. Now we will plug in a USB-C cable to connect the two machines. Pay attention to the USB-C port location on the Mac. There is only one port to run the software via DFU. Then turn off the Mac that needs to be downgraded and press the power button to turn it on while holding the key combination as instructed by the software for about 10 seconds. When your Mac enters DFU mode, the software will automatically switch to the firmware download interface. Note that at this time, the Mac screen will be black, not displaying any information. Click Download to start downloading the firmware. Then select Downgrade again, and the downgrade process will automatically take place. At this step, the software displays instructions for you to continue the process. Just follow the instructions as shown. First, press the power button for about 3 seconds, then press and hold the Option plus Command plus R key combination until the screen lights up. We will need to select a Wi-Fi network and connect, and wait a bit for macOS to start internet recovery. Then you will need to reconnect to Wi-Fi and enter the Apple ID account that was previously logged in on the machine to activate the machine. When the activation is complete, select Exit to Recovery. Here, you will select Disk Utility, and we will select the Macintosh HD drive again. Then click Erase and select Erase again to clean the drive. Now go back to the recovery menu and select Reinstall macOS Sonoma. Select Continue. Select Continue again. Now agree to the terms, and the installation process will automatically take place. You just need to wait for the system. Thus, I have finished guiding you on two ways to downgrade macOS from Sequoia to Sonoma. How was your experience after using the macOS 15 beta version for a while? Did you encounter any errors? Share with me in the comments section. Goodbye and see you again.